I am Hannah Faye. I am from Adeso. I was incarcerated together with my mother and sister. We went to farm to get some maize. We were trying to locate the farm owner to ask for permission.
The testimony of an inmate of the Nsawom prison who was convicted for allegedly stealing half a sack of maize. She shares her cell with her mom and another sibling who had accompanied them to a neighbor's farm that fateful day.
We were sent to the police station, processed for court and sentenced. We were to serve our sentence at the Nsawom prison. We pleaded that we have children and that my sister was carrying a baby, but that didn't yield much. We are in prison with my sister's child.
Her story reflects the state of Ghana's judicial system, overcrowding, inmates remanded without trial, and long jail terms handed people for crimes many consider minor, dominate discussions on custodial sentences. The forum brought together the Chief Justice Sufaya Kufu, representatives from the Interior Ministry, Police and Prison Service. CJ Sufaya Kufu urged the convict to appeal the sentence.
So there can be an application to the supervising High Court judge to review the sentence, not the conviction, but the sentence. Or there can be appeal. Appeals take a longer time. These applications can be within 48 hours. So I think your paralegal person should even have been able to draw up one of those applications on her behalf. And it's better that we deal with these situations rather than as soon as we come across them, rather than just create opportunities for sensationalization. Not that I'm criticizing, but all I'm saying is that, so what did POS Foundation and your paralegals, what did you do? Because this is such a simple matter and it could have been resolved. So please, I'm expecting you to act on it, and next week by this time, things would have been sorted out.
Deputy Commissioner of Shraj, Richard Kwesin, called for a swift passage of the law regulating non-custodial sentence.
And though somebody may describe the offense as stealing and therefore the punishment is imprisonment, I still believe that that is not our sense of what is fair, what is just, and what is decent. And for this reason, I believe that all of us here should take this morning's exercise very seriously and do what is needful. 2 decades of discussions and consultations on non-custodial sentencing should end somewhere.
Similar stakeholder engagements are expected to be organized in other parts of the country.